Yo, what's going on guys? Gastom here, and welcome back to another wonderful video on this channel. And today's video, we're actually going to have another base tour. This base tour is a little bit different, however, because the person who made this base has chosen not to be named, and has also chosen not to actually give the server that this base is on, I guess. So, I'm not going to be doing any of that. This is just a base I am touring. However, I really like it because it's really redstone driven. As you can see, it's not the best looking base, but it does have its own unique sense of beauty with the torches, with the cactus farm. But without further ado, let's just get into the parts of this base. So we start off and we have this nice iron farm. So this type of thing really blows me away. Something that I did notice though, it's like how small this iron farm is. Like most of them that you see are like huge, and this one is like really compact. And I think that's nice. I don't know how iron farms work. However, it's really cool. And next up, we have this huge sorting system. It sorts everything from like blocks to more blocks, I guess. I meant like building blocks to ores, and also resource blocks. Just, it's really big. I thought mine and my base was big, but this one is like stacked on stacked. And next up, we're gonna have a bamboo farm, which I don't know how it works, to be honest. It is completely out of my skill level when it comes to redstone, but apparently the only reason this flying machine is stopped is, this is according to the guy, it's because the server runs on a plugin called Bucket, which isn't too good with redstone, so the flying machine will break down often, which it's apparently not that hard to reset up, but I wouldn't know. And next up we have a nice cactus farm, which this is more on my like skill level. I know that when the cactus grows, it doesn't like to touch any of these random giblets. So it'll actually just fall down and be picked up by the hoppers and will be transported somehow to be cooked, most likely, right there. Here's the auto carpet farm. It repeatedly just duped the carpet over and over, so that's cool. I get really easily excited about redstone things because I'm not really that redstone minded. Also, this floating torch is pretty cool. So how this farm works, it only works during the day, but the drowns will spawn down and they'll fall down here. Well, when I'm not standing there. They'll fall down here and they'll go after that turtle egg, which they'll then step on the magma block and die, and all of their items will just go into these chests. I don't know how they drop pink banners, but everything else fits. And right up here, we have, well, that's a rip, isn't it? And I've made it to the top of this. So, I actually had to throw a whole bunch of ender pearls and died another time, but we have made it. Ooh, a sword. That's fancy. But we have a nice villager farm in this section of the base, and an auto wheat farm, which I thought was impossible. There's ways of getting golden carrots for carrots that come from the auto farm. Must not be an auto wheat farm, must be like a auto carrot farm. Yeah, it looks like it. All the villagers here have just about any trade that you'd want, and for the actual guy who made this base, they're all at the minimum price. As in, he's had them killed, cured, killed, cured, until he's probably paying an emerald per book, which is a really good price. Also, this zombie is named Dirk after a friend of the person who made this his dad. So, shout out to Dirk. As you guys can see, this base actually doesn't look bad. Like, you would think that if you focused only on the utility of a base, it would end up looking, like, horrid. But it somehow doesn't. I mean, it's by no means the prettiest base I've ever seen, but that's a trade-off, because it has so much usefulness. Overall, I really like this base, and I like how the guy builds. he builds for utility. It was actually a second base that the man asked me to show you guys. So this is actually his starter base before he actually went and built the bigger one. As you can see, he still has his auto sorter, his auto smelter, all of the regular things that you see in most bases. But he also has a whole lot of farms as well. Like this thing, for instance. To be honest, I couldn't tell you what it does, but it for sure does something. And this coming up right here is actually a creeper farm. Which, don't ask me, because I have no idea how you can only farm creepers and not other mobs, because you know, like, usually when creepers spawn, other mobs, such as like zombies and skeletons spawn, but somehow he's figured out how to make this an exclusively creeper farm. Well, just about exclusively, but yeah, that's that. And coming up right around here, we have an iron golem farm, because as the guy stated, it takes a whole lot of iron to make redstone machines, so he has to have an iron farm at whatever base he currently resides at. Which makes sense. I wish I had an iron farm too, to be honest. Here's just a regular auto fisher. I don't know if it still works, because I remember they got patched at one point, or something like that. I don't know. Here is another auto farm, with Lilith being the farmer, and Essen. So shout out to whoever they're named after. Right up here is a honey farm. It is complete with dead bees. As you can see, there's also a lot of redstone here. And fire, a whole lot of fire. Coming up around here, we have another villager hall. It's nothing special compared to the other ones. I'm sure the villagers are cured and everything for him once again. And coming up right here, we have a tree farm. It's nothing really that special. Like, this is like a me level design. It just seems to be, yeah, just all of the items end up here. So guys, here I am back on Era. I am going to end the video here. I have a couple things to say before I actually do. Of course, if you want me to tour your base, just message me in game or leave a comment down below. And just pretty much get in contact with me in any way you can. And as well, I'm making a drama alert Mindwind style video, so if you guys have any stories that you think would be good enough to put in it, then I would be glad to take them. And finally, leave a like down below and subscribe, and remember not to eat rotten carrots. Goodbye.